Good morning all. Today I'm going to take the session Common Gateway Interface CGI. The Common Gateway Interface CGI is a specification defined by W3C, means World Wide Web Consortium, defining how a program interacts with a Hypertext Transfer Protocol server. The Common Gateway Interface provides the middleware between WWW servers and external databases and information sources. CGI applications perform specific information processing, retrieval, and formatting tasks on behalf of WWW World Wide Web servers. Why is CGI used? An interesting aspect of CGI-enabled web server is that computer program can be created and deployed that can accept user input and create a web page. Unlike static web page that displays some preset information, this interactive web page enables a client to send information to the web server and get back a response that depends on the input. A web search engine is a good example of an interactive web page. The client enters one or more keywords and the web index returns a list of web pages that satisfy the search criteria entered. The web page returned by the web index is also dynamic because the content of that page depends on what the client types in as search words. CGI is a standard way for a web server to pass a web user's request to an application program and to receive data back to forward to the user. Let us take an example. So when you are going to open a web browser, you will be giving HTTP request to the server. Then the server will be sending the request to the database. So basically, the web pages and everything stored in the database. To get them from database, we will be using a particular method, that is nothing CGI program. CGI is a common gateway interface. It's an interface between server and database. It is used to provide dynamic content to the user. Basically, dynamic is nothing but based on your request, the content on the page update. This process will be going when we are going for a dynamic web pages. And CGI is used to execute a program that resides in the server to process data or access database to produce the relevant dynamic content. As I already told, CGI acts as an interface between a server and an application. CGI enables the web server to handle client requests such as from web browsers and passing it to the right application. CGI programs may be written in any programming language like the Common Gateway Interface is a protocol describing a standard way of providing server-side active web content under circumstances determined by the server. An HTTP request will cause a program to run. The output from the program will be the response returned to the client making the request. Servers can identify CGI programs by their addresses on the server or by file extension. When a server receives a request for a CGI program, it does not return the file. It executes the program in the file and returns that program output. It may be an HTML document. In other words, user enters the input into the web-based form and click the submit button. Browser packs the input entered in form field according to the CGI specifications and send request to web server using HTTP. Web server process the request, extract the program and pass information onto the CGI. The CGI accept the information and communicates with any resource necessary to process the request, such as database or file server. CGI returns the result or an error message of the program as HTML back to the web server. The web server takes the output, standard output of the program, and sends HTML back to the browser. A web server that supports CGI can be configured to interpret a URL that it serves as a reference to CGI script. A common convention is to have a CGI /directory at the base of the directory tree and treat all executable files within this directory. Another popular convention is to use file name extension. For instance, if CGI scripts are constantly given the extension .cgi, the web server can be configured to interpret all such files as CGI script. If you are going a website and want a CGI application to get control, it need to specify the name of the application in the uniform resource locator that we code in an HTML file. This URL can be specified as part of the forms tag if you are creating a form. For example, form method equal to post to action equal to http://www.mybiz.com/cgi/bin/formprog.pl. The server at mybiz.com will pass control to CGI application called formprog.pl to record the entered data and return a confirmation message. The .pl indicates a program written in Perl, and other language can also use such as C, C++, like that. Basically, CGI web server, when there are multiple requests, such as CGI request 1, CGI request 2, like that, then it creates a multiple process. Process 1, process 2, like that. These processes are heavy. This is the major drawback of CGI. Let us go to the disadvantage of CGI. For each CGI server request and process is created. If number of requests increases, then number of process also increases. Hence, at some point, response will take time, means delay will start. Then CGI scripts are written in native language. As I already told, this CGI scripts written in C, C++, Java, like that. Hence, C, C++, all are platform dependent. This is the major disadvantage of CGI. Thank you.